तीन मिनट है.
नो सर, आई एम द लीडर ऑफ माई ग्रुप. वी हैव 18 मेंबर्स, आई मस्ट हैव 10 मिनट्स.
यू आर हैविंग टोटल 10 मिनट्स, 3 मेंबर्स.
आई एम सॉरी सर, आई वोंट स्पीक, समबडी एल्स कैन स्पीक.
आप बैठिए भैया, बोलिए गोरे नरेश जी, बोलिए.
पार्लियामेंट
आप अपने जगह पर जाइए. शुक्ला जी गो देर, शुक्ला जी गो देर.
आप पूरे टाइम सर आप टोकते रहते.
आप सब लोग बैठ जाइए. यू सिट डाउन, आई विल टेक केयर. आप क्यों ऐसा कर रहे हैं? बैठ जाइए, बोलिए नरेश गुजराल जी.
ठीक है,
बैठ जाइए, बैठ जाइए. टाइम जाएगा, बैठ जाइए.
थैंक यू सर. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई लाइक टू स्टार्ट, आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट बाय एक्सप्रेसिंग माय सिंपथीज विद माय फेलो मेंबर्स हु आर हियर. कमिटमेंट्स वर मेड टू आंध्र प्रदेश इन दिस हाउस व्हिच अनफॉर्चुनेटली collectively have not been kept, and I feel sorry that their demands are not being met, and I hope the Honorable Finance Minister will look at their demands favorably. Sir, having said that, I feel that this is the most challenging budget for the Honorable Finance Minister since his government came to power. Why is it challenging? Because oil prices have hardened and are today in the vicinity of $65 to $70 a barrel. For 4 years he had the cushion of soft oil prices with which he could pursue giving money to the social sector. Second, sir, there is acute farm distress in the country. And the third, there is underutilized capacity in manufacturing and the power sector, which is not creating fresh jobs. At the same time, he has to maintain fiscal discipline because the country wants to send a message to the international investor that we will be fiscally responsible so that FDI keeps coming to India. Having said that, I congratulate the finance minister that he has taken a holistic view by pumping in money to the rural sector, and I call it a paradigm shift in the way we look at agriculture and agriculturists in this country. Sir, it was very strange that despite the fact that 65% of India's population is dependent on the farm, 49% of the jobs are created in the agriculture sector, yet we were shortchanging our farmer by not giving him adequate prices for goods. What were we doing? We were saying, let's not give him a high price because that will create inflation. So the poor farmer was suffering. Every time international prices went up, we would put a ban on export, because again we wanted to protect a constituency in India, which was the urban constituency, and the farm sector kept suffering. So I congratulate the finance minister that he has said and kept the promise that the farmer will get 150% of his cost, which means cost plus 50%. Now, Mr. Chidambaram, Neeraj Chandrasekhar and many others have raised which formula. Is it A2 plus FL? Is it C2? Sir, I am not getting into any formulas. Yesterday, one of the Congress members had said, Mr. Chidambaram probably, that in their tenure, they doubled the prices of the farm sector in 10 years. Neeraj ji, that works out to 6% compounded per annum. This is what the farmer was getting when the inflation rate was in double digits. So every year, the poor farmer was forced to commit suicide. Thank God that now the finance minister has said that the farmer will get a just deal. So not getting into the details of which formula it is, I will only urge the finance minister that the next crop is coming in 2 months. We have raised the hopes of the farmer of this country. They are expecting a new deal, a big deal. Please do not let down the farmer of India, because if you do, you will see the kind of despair, suicides, and frustration that this country has never seen before. So I do hope that I, as I said, I'm not getting into the formulas, but I do hope that the farmer will finally get a proper deal. Sir, second, how does a farmer get so poor and eventually commit suicide when he's so frustrated? Number one, he doesn't get adequate price for his produce. Number two, the health care cost. Somebody falls ill in his family, he begs, borrows at high interest rates, and then gets the patient treated. And third is marriages. This budget has taken care of the first two, adequate farm prices, and B, making sure that the poor in this country will be treated by the government up to 5 lakhs per family, which I think is a phenomenal announcement. But again, it must be honored in letter and spirit. Only will the poor of this country feel satisfied. And I would also urge the Prime Minister, the way he has carried the campaign of Swachh Bharat, I hope something is done that we curtail expenses on marriages in this country, and some kind of a social campaign needs to be unleashed, because that will help the farmer. Sir, having said that, jobs have to be created. Now the Finance Minister has pumped in money, will pump in money into the farm sector. 6 lakh crore is going into the infrastructure sector. He is making sure that the textile sector, which is the second largest generator of jobs after the farm sector, will get its due and jobs will be created there. And also he has tweaked the labor laws so that till now it was that you could hire but not fire, but by giving fixed term contracts, this will ensure that industries start to hire more people. Sir, I am an optimist. The way BJP has followed and NDA has followed economic policies, I am convinced this we will see double-digit growth very soon. And the proof of that is the way FDI is coming to India. They are not fools. They know that this country will have the market, this country is growing, and this country is following the right economic policies, and that is why they are coming to India. And this is very important, sir, because our domestic rate of savings is now stagnant at 29% for a very long time. We need the FDI investment. This year it's about $60 billion, and I think it will increase as our market becomes better. Because what happens is, when there is demand, only then factories start working to full capacity. And this is what this finance minister is doing. He is creating the demand. And this will set in motion a virtuous cycle. When factories start working to full capacity, they will have to hire more people. When more people are hired, that will create more demand. And when there is more demand, only then private sector investment will start coming in. And I have no doubt in my mind that NDA will ensure that this economy gets regenerated. This budget has given it a kickstart, and I'm convinced that going forward, this country will soon see double-digit growth, and I congratulate the Finance Minister for that. Thank you very much, sir.
Dhanyavaad, Sri.